China is slamming Vice President Mike Pence for his support of pro-democracy protesters in Hong Kong. The foreign minister calling it, quote, arrogance and hypocrisy after the vice president criticized the NBA for its part in this free speech dispute with China.
And some of the NBA's biggest players and owners who routinely exercise their freedom to criticize this country lose their voices when it comes to the freedom and rights of the people of China. In siding with the Chinese Communist Party and silencing free speech, the NBA is acting like a wholly owned subsidiary of that authoritarian regime.
All right, joining us now is Ian Bremmer, the president and founder of Eurasia Group and G-Zero Media. Ian, it's great to have you here. And Mike Pence, he has said that before. And the criticism of the NBA is one actually I know that you share and has been out there. But President Trump hasn't exactly been a vocal defender of the protesters in Hong Kong.
Human rights generally has taken a back seat in this administration's foreign policy. Trump specifically has said that he's not going to bring up Hong Kong as long as the trade talks are ongoing. Getting that done is something that feels more urgent for him right now, with the U.S. economy softening and the impact of the trade deal on the U.S. economy growing. But there's no question, Pence was out there loud and proud on the Uyghurs, on NBA, on Hong Kong. That is different than the message you'll be hearing from President Trump directly.
But chastising the NBA, but not having your own boss say anything about China, is that hypocritical?
Well, I mean, Pence's point historically has been that these American companies should be more patriotic. And to be fair, the NBA isn't just not taking a position. They forced the Houston Rockets' Morey to take his tweet down that was supporting the Hong Kong demonstrators. The owner of the New Jersey Nets wrote a three-page pro-Beijing communist screed against Hong Kong. It's still up today, right? So, I mean, this is the equivalent would be if the NBA was only writing about Trump in a positive way, only talking about Trump in a positive way, and never letting their players or management say anything negative about the American administration. It'd be inconceivable for them to do that in the United States, and yet that actually is the position de facto in China, which is kind of extraordinary. It'd be weird for the administration not to be calling that out, frankly.
Interesting also, just how far the reach of this has gone and how much we hear about this discussion now that we're two or three games into the NBA season. Charles Barkley commented on Mike Pence's remarks last night. Listen to this.
Vice President Pence needs to shut the hell up. These holier than thou politicians, if they so want to worry about China, won't they stop all transactions with China? I think it's unfair for them to do all their business in China, and just because this thing happened, try to make the NBA and our players look bad. All American companies do business in China.
So what do you think of what Sir Charles had to say there?
Well, I mean, if that was on TNT, I want to see what Shaq said back to him, because Shaq is the one person out there affiliated with the NBA that's had the willingness to go out and say, I support Morey, shouldn't have taken that down. It was the right thing. It was courageous for him to do. While LeBron is like, oh, no, no, no. He wasn't educated on China. LeBron, of course, very educated on China. Give me a break. Now, the reason LeBron can do that, I mean, the reason Shaq can do that is because he's not a current player. Current player can't do it. I understand Barkley completely. There's absolutely hypocrisy in Trump on human rights on this issue. But to say that the NBA shouldn't be open to criticism, given their position in the U.S. and the position in China, we've got a much bigger problem, which is that American companies that like to have global values, they like to say we're about democracy and free speech, but suddenly one of their biggest markets in the world, and soon to be the largest economy in the world, is a country that says, if you want to play ball here, quite literally, you're going to have to change your view of those values. And most of these companies are absolutely willing to do it. I mean, in my field, we don't take money from Chinese companies, right? And if we did, my ability to get on with you guys this morning and have this conversation would be seriously constrained. My analysts would be under pressure. They'd say, you want to keep working with us? No way. The banks have this problem. The big consulting firms have this problem. This is not limited to the NBA, but the NBA has really stepped in it. Let's put it that way.
Can't Shaq just say whatever he wants?
I think Shaq can say whatever he wants. I think Barkley can too. These are big boys.
Yeah. Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
I've interviewed Shaq once. I came up to, like, his thigh.
Yeah. I mean, like, if he was saying this directly on the show right now, I'd be, yes, sir. Yeah, absolutely.
I'm glad we know where your allegiances lie. Okay. Ian, thank you.
Sure. Good to see you guys.
Great to see you, too. Yeah.